getting to know you, getting to know all about you, getting to like you, getting to hope you like me. Hi, all. So today we're going to do something a little bit different. I thought it would be fun to maybe connect with some of the people from our church. And today what I want to do is interview Brian. So let's go to Zoom.
Hi. Hi, Brian.
Mona. Hello.
How are you?
I'm well. Thank you. How are you?
I can probably, can I see you? Oh, look at that.
Wow.
Just in case it doesn't record. How are you doing?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
Very good. This is kind of silly, actually. Why don't you come here? Because we're actually socially distancing each other from each other together. Yes. In the house.
Yes, I'm working in the office formerly known as Tyler's bedroom.
Yes, so why don't you come and join me here?
Okay.
Okay, great. Right. See you in a minute. Let's see how long it takes him to come. All right. So here comes Brian. He's going to come here. We're going to set up a chair for him. Hey, why don't you grab that chair right there and you pull that in. Okay, so Brian, thank you for joining me today.
Hello. Yes, hello. Happy to be here.
Yes, okay. So let me just ask you a couple of questions. They don't need to see me. I need to see you.
Okay. Don't need to see me either.
No, no. Welcome to my office. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, my pleasure.
So I'd like to ask you, how are you doing in the midst of all this madness? How are you doing?
Well, I think as well as could be expected under the circumstances.
Right. Talk to me about that.
I'm doing fine. But that requires a degree of introspection that sometimes I'm not very good at.
Right.
So sometimes others are much better at telling me how I am doing than I am able to determine for myself.
That is very, very correct. My question is, I think you've been very busy. Is that true in the midst of all this?
It's been a strangely busy time. I provide support to teams in the Ministry of Health who are developing COVID-19 information systems. So it's an extraordinarily busy time for those folks and for me.
So tell me, how are you dealing with, I'm presuming you have some anxiety over this because it's a very busy time for you and you are having to work all hours of the day and night, and it's a very unusual time. So how are you coping with the stress of that? Not only the stress of this pandemic, but of your work. How are you managing that?
Well, I think it's important for me to take some time out, even in days that are very busy, just to stop and take interviews, for example.
Yes, very good that you've done that. Thank you so much.
That use a different part of my brain and help to focus on things other than the immediate issues of work and so on.
Right. Okay. So then also, are there any specific coping strategies besides taking this interview?
No, that's today. Today's coping strategy is an interview.
Wow! But do you do anything else? Like, have you? No.
I think it's just a case of taking some time when you can to stop thinking about the immediate and
right.
Think of things that are a little more important actually in the overall scheme of things. The COVID-19 will pass, but relationships with family and loved ones, those are enduring. And so I think it's a bit of focusing when I can on others in my immediate isolated family.
Great. Excellent. Okay, so big question. Where have you seen God in this?
I think there's lots of opportunities to see God at work, I think, through this pandemic experience. We've seen people rally around needs, whether it's calling someone who's more isolated than they would otherwise be, picking up something from a store if you're making a run to get essential things, leaving food on doorsteps, and we've delivered some food, we've been the recipients of some food in our little context here, and these are things that just I think help others and help each of us recognize that there's a world outside of the four walls of where we're isolating. Mm-hmm. I think technology has offered some great opportunities for creating communities in different ways, and even this Zoom facility that we're using right now.
Yeah, even in our own house.
In our own house.
With each other.
With her, yes, amongst ourselves. And, yeah. But I think as a church family, we've been able to create opportunities for community. Using technology. We had a meeting with my men's group, as you know, last Thursday, and we got together virtually and just had a really good conversation about how each one of us is doing in the midst of a thing that's very disruptive to our lives and causes stress. And so it was good to do that. I think it was good for all of us. It was certainly good for me to be a part of that.
That's great. That's good. Well, thank you so much for your time, Brian.
It's my pleasure.
It's been very nice to sit and chat with you. And I hope we can do this again. Thank you again.
Too. And and what would you like for lunch?
Anything you want to make. Love you. Bye. So that was our first little interview. I think that was fun. Well, anyway, we're going to do more of that. I think it'd be really great to hear from one another. So if you're willing to be a part of this little video dialogue, let me know. Just send me a text or an email, and I'd love to have a little interview. We'll do it via Zoom, and we can record it, and we can put together a little devotional. We have a lot to say to one another, and as Brian mentioned, we have the technology to connect with one another even in the midst of isolation. So stay tuned. We're going to talk to some more people, and I love you all so much. We'll talk real soon. Bye.